Welcome back, fellow coders. Jared O'Leary here with BootUp. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can actually make the game progressively faster using variables. So what I want to do is make it so that instead of the food falling at the same speed throughout the project, I want it to get faster. And I'm going to do that in a couple of different ways. So I'm going to create a new variable under variables, make a variable, and I'm going to call it speed. You could call it something like falling speed, whatever. And now I have two variables that I can use. My score and my speed. Oh, by the way, this checkbox, if you click it, it makes it so that it hides up here so you don't have to see your stuff. I'll keep it up so that way you can see it changing. Anyways, okay, these blocks right here, we can actually take them and put them in any one of these white spaces that you could normally put like a number or even letters or whatever. So instead of changing by -5, I'm actually gonna change by my speed. Now, you'll notice it's not moving at all because my speed is currently set to 0. So when my project starts, I want to set my speed to a negative number, like -5, and I'll click on this, and it sets it to that. Now, pick a number that works for you, like -10 would make it go a lot faster. -1 make it go really slow. Now, I'm gonna show you two different ways that you can actually make the game get faster and faster. So one, I'm going to use a when green flag is clicked, and I'm going to forever wait 1 second, and then I'm going to change the variable speed by -1, again, because we're falling. So now when I run this, every second, this is gonna get faster. So see how this number is getting higher and how my sprite is falling faster and faster? Okay, so that got really fast really quick. So what I could do is say, hey, wait maybe 5 seconds before changing by one, or I could say change it by like -0.1. So every second, it only goes a little bit faster, 0.1, 0.2. Cool. So that's one option for making it so that your game gets progressively faster. So this is always going to get faster no matter what you do. Now, another option is actually a conditional way of doing this. Okay, so now I want to make it so that instead of it getting faster every second, I want to make it so that we actually change by what our score is. So if we have a high score, it's going to go fast, and if we have a low score, it's going to go slow. So we actually don't even need the speed block to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these. All I need to use is my score block. And we're gonna go ahead and use a conditional that's basically gonna say if our score is greater than 0, if score is greater than 0, we're going to change by our score. Otherwise, we're just going to change by -5. So if we have a negative score, it'll always just go at -5, or if we have a score of 0, it'll always go at -5 for a speed. So if we run it, still going. But as soon as we get a score of 1, right now it's stopping. The reason why is because we have to add in a couple of blocks. So we're going to add in a change y, but I don't want it to go by this. I want it to go by the starting speed, -5, minus our score. Okay, so now when I'm doing this, as I get a higher score, see how my banana is getting faster and faster? And if I get a lower score, my banana gets slower and slower. Cool? So that was two different ways that you can actually change the speed using variables. One was creating a speed variable and having it change every second or every couple of seconds. The other is using our score variable with this if-else conditional that says if our score is greater than 0, we're going to change by the starting speed minus our score. Otherwise, it's always going to go by -5, which is the speed that it is right now. So add code like this into your project to make the game progressively challenging. Hey everyone, if you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. If you're not watching us on YouTube, you can find us on that platform as well as other social media outlets by searching for BootUp PD. And if you're looking for more free lessons, projects, and resources for teachers and students, visit us at bootuppd.org, where you can also learn about our high-quality professional development.